Everybody, Icelandic Farmer here, and welcome back to Sosnovska Not by Johnny Wee. Well, last episode we went through a little bit about, about this new stuff with the version 3 from Johnny, and for those who haven't seen it, this over there is a fertilizer master, this is a seed master, and there is a liquid fertilizer master. I have, before the recording here, I filled this one up with slurry and manure, and we have 12,000 in already. But Johnny talked about something, standing under the pipe, you can't do that when you are in a tractor, you need to go out and change to manual or auto filling. So now it is on manual charging, and now it's on automatic charging. That means that when you drive a trailer or whatever under, it will fill automatically. When it does on automatic, if it does on manual, it actually you need to press the R button to start loading. So I'm gonna do that on all these machinery, even the mix feeders. They actually works the same. You need to go under the pipe and press R to be able to put it on automatic. So the only thing you need to do is just drive under the pipe with your trailer and it will start to fill. So let's put it all on that. Well, I have been talking about this oil race, all oil radis. We are going to seed them now, but first, before we go out with that tractor on that field, I want to put this one under the pipe of the fertilizer, because it takes so long time to empty these machines. So while we are doing starting to seed, he will start fill there. So let's go here. Isn't it still filling? Yes, it is. So we filled. This is the mod from Johnny. It's just a basic seeder, the Amazon Condor. Just he have changed the volumes on seeds and fertilizers. So now we have 6,000 liters of seed and 3,000 on fertilizer. And it's more closer to the truth if you ask me. But that is my opinion. So let's go down. We talked about putting actually oil radis down here on field 9 just to test it, because I haven't tested it yet, and it's a totally new stuff that I just haven't gotten myself into to test yet. So let's unfold this one and line it up here. There. Don't think we no. It's fine. So the max speed on this one is actually what, 16 kilometers or something, if I remember right. So we will see how this is going to go. Actually, Johnny had quite a laugh of me from my last video. He was saying that I was doing everything wrong. What I want to do, and see if he was right or not, because I tried to fill the seeder with fertilizer under the pipe, but I just could not do it in any way. So when this one is finished seeding here, we could test to fill it up from the fertilizer master. So let's just take the headland in this end. Let's see, we need to... There. Have it on, yeah, manual. There, don't need to have it on outdoor anyway. I'm not gonna put any lanes in here anyway, so... I'm using the ProSeed mod. It actually just makes the possibility to put lanes in the fields, so you can see where you should spray. I think it is useful for me personally, but it makes it a little bit more look like more realistic, if you ask me. But we all have our own opinion on that stuff. So let's see, let's line this one up and put a high worker on this one. And now he can go. There. So they are... Why aren't you lined up? Seems to be like I need to line them up every time I start the game. Seems to be. Still not totally lined up, you can see. Need to go a little bit further there. And let's see if this is going to be okay. Put a high worker on. It's the same on this one. Try to line them up. Something like this. There. Last one. This one we need to take further away because it is actually too close. Something like this, maybe. There. Let's see. Yeah, now it's actually full. So that's good. It takes us a little time for it to empty. The good thing I think about this stuff, it is actually going to save us quite a lot of money. But the thing is, it's just giving us more work on the farm. You are able to make your own fertilizer and own seeds. I'm not going to use liquid fertilizer because I never use it. I usually just use a solid one. So what I'm doing now, I'm putting fertilizer into the seed master so we can produce some seeds. So there. The other thing we need to do is we need to fill up the pig mix feeder and the cow mix feeder. I have put in all our hay bales, not balls. Oh my god, what I'm saying. Well, bales. So finally, I could use the hay bales that I had and filled it up. We need 4,000 liters more to fill it up. It takes 100,000 liters in each silo here. So we haven't put in any straw. So let's do that. Let's get some straw. I wonder how much straw you have. You're not probably going to have enough. You're probably going to need to make straw out of the wheat that we are soon going to harvest. We just haven't had time for corn, potatoes, wheat, expression, chaff, straw. We have at least 75,000. How are the animals with straw? Do we need to give them any straw right now? No. They are actually having everything that they need for now. So we can wait until we will get more straw in the next harvest. So it's no biggie there. So let's bring this load. Actually cleaned this tractor and tipper for the handling of the feeding. So we have a clean machinery for that. It's not looking good when you're driving around with a really filthy tractor and tipper and make a feed for the animals. Need to try to have it as clean as possible. So let's see, I can just actually jump in here. Being cab. We have quite a lot of hours on this tractor. 24 hours. That's quite a lot actually. I haven't decided totally if we're going to be like say 50 hours on each tractor, and when they're up to 50 hours we need to change them, something like that. Well, now he's finished harvesting. Oh sorry, not harvesting. Why aren't they going? Well, let's just finish that so he we can make sure that everything is seeded here. I don't know how long time the oil radish needs to grow. I think it is about the same time as the other crops, but I don't know. So now that is done, what we should do, we need if we go in and look at our storage, we have quite a lot of potatoes, we have a lot of corn, we have a little bit of canola, and a little bit of wheat. We are going to not have enough to give to the pigs, so we need to seed wheat, barley, and sunflowers. Soybeans we already have in one field. What I'm doing, let's see here, growth, these are growing, soon we can actually harvest them, but we have soybeans here and actually wheat there, so we will get more wheat if we harvest this one, so we can put that into the pig mix feeder anyway. So we'll just wait until these oil radish will grow, and then we will cultivate them, and then we will seed the field one more time, and then I don't think we need to actually fertilize it anymore. I think we have it all done then. I sold 9 pigs, so we have now a total of 58 pigs? 57 or 58, I don't remember. I have decided to go do it like this, sell 9 pigs every day until we get up to about 100 pigs in the herd. I want to have about 100 pigs always in the herd. So let's open this and see if we can. Yeah, it actually did this time. Well, Johnny, you were right. And I was wrong. It did work this time. So let's see, can we fill it up with the seeds too? Let's open it up. Should not be a problem. Why I can't get close enough? I did actually fill it up yesterday, if I remember there. Whoa. There. These pipes should be longer, if you ask me. So you don't need to get so close. But you should maybe be able to put some of it in storage. I don't think we will be able to do that in the main storage, I think. Let's see, let's drive. If he hasn't changed that, we could actually look through that when we go and get the second, third load of straw. The rest of them. Rest of the straw. This is actually making a lot of things going on all the time now because of these new stuff that we have. I can't see anything behind me with this trailer on. There was the steering wheel. It's actually turning too much. So as you can see, it's already starting to mix together. After we have emptied the last of the straw, we will can able to see how much we have already made. No, wrong way. Why? Yeah. That is when you don't have a reset camera when you change views. Then this can happen. So let's see, straw, pig food, grass, hay, wheat, silage, wood chips, chaff, sort of mixed dressing, chicken, potatoes. No, there is no any able to store seeds or fertilizer in the storage at all. So we probably need to maybe make our own. I don't know. Maybe. Or we just always make sure that they are full, the tank, at the seeds and the fertilizer, and we just fill from there. I think that is the best option. Anyway, so let's see. Let's. Doing the same as I did in 15, press Q, then you detach the trailer. So now we have filled what we have into this, and yeah, you already have 3,199 liters. So now we need to put in some canola and sunflowers. I think we just need to take what we have in stock. There. Sunflowers. Empty that. Was that all? Okay, yeah, that was actually all. I thought we had more. I thought it was 8,000. Yeah. Now we just have 844. So that was not much. let's see. It's the middle one. Because the one all the way to right is corn and the other one is potatoes or sugar beet. So now we can take canola. The good thing with this new update was that I could pick up the rest of the corn that I have laying in the sheds over there and the potatoes. So we don't have any potatoes and corn laying around. So that is at least a good thing. We still have the no room for the wood chips that are laying there. So we need to take that probably and sell it when we get a good price. And we just need to load it up with the telehandler. I have actually been thinking about changing the telehandler to a wheel loader because it goes faster with a wheel loader. The telehandler need to, 7 or 8 buckets to fill the trailer here. If I had a wheel loader, that would be enough with 3 buckets. Goes quite a lot faster and easier to use, I think. Now that when the farm is actually getting so big, the animals are just getting more and more animals all the time. They're almost up to 60 cows. So let's see, if we speed up time like 60. Just for the oil radish. Let's keep on putting some canola in there. Now we're going to growth. It's probably going to be the same, but everything is in good status with animals, if I remember right. They are good for at least one more day. I just want to see these oil radish, how that is going to work. By the way, the fertilizing. Yeah. Why is it looking so strange? Looks really strange. Well, we will see when the oil radish are actually grown, and we will cultivate them if that is actually going to help with fertilizing there, because it is so strangely well. Come on, why are you driving into me? Yeah, these stripes. I think the fault is actually mostly the chopped straw. When we chop the straw down, we will get these stripes because it will be a little bit on the field that will not get any straw at all. And I think that it can even be the harvester isn't spraying it evenly as it should. The mussy that we have isn't spraying, because when he goes back and forth, he every second lane he will leave a line that isn't covered with straw. So that is what it is, I think. Let's see. Put this one in. Then we don't have any more canola, so we need. We need to harvest a lot of stuff. Because of all of this, we are running out of everything except corn and potatoes. We have a lot of that. Canola, barley, wheat. No, why am... No, I was not going to take wheat, it was corn or potatoes. Oh, me sometimes. Not paying attention to what I'm doing. Terrible stuff. I blame it on the age. I'm getting old. My short memory isn't good. Probably that. Or it could be just plain stupidity. Nothing else, I think. So we're going to for corn. That we have a lot of. The thing is, it actually gives you, these mix feeders will give you 150,000 liters when they are, the tank is full in them. And that is actually going to be enough for us for quite a while. I'm not sure if we are having, if we have 100 pigs, how much that is actually going to... How much they are going to need for 6 days in liters. But we will quite soon find out about that, I think. Everything is going down there, straw and the hay. We are going to need to do quite a lot of work by making hay bales and or just make it plain hay and just pick it up with a loading wagon. Either one. We have a good bale shed over there now. This is actually the same as was on Polish Agro Farm, if I remember right. Looks like it, at least. Let's see. No, wrong button. How is the growth? It's still, yes, they're actually is growing the same. These one are ready. Isn't it closer to now? Still here on the same growth states. Just have to go down there a little bit later and see if there is any change on the field. I'm just gonna put this trailer, and then we need to put in potatoes because we don't have that much canola and such. We have, what is it? 54,000. And how much is this on corn now? 38. I'll put one more load of corn. Still the same. So there. I think we start to need to do change. Actually, should change this one to a bigger tractor soon, because I feel this one is actually struggling a little bit pulling this trailer, even though this is 240 horsepower. Need to go up to some 300 or something. castle there. And now we go over to potatoes. Potatoes. Earth apples. No. As you can call them here. Dirt apples or whatever. I think they called that on like earth apples earlier in old times, if I'm not wrong. Through to the night here. We just put this trailer in and I think we will stop on tipping in here. I can do that off screen later on. So let's see, how much do we have in this one now? Is it full? Yeah, this one is totally full. How is in this one? Yeah, it's almost getting full too. So we don't need to fill into this one right now. There's no panicking on that. So let's see. Let's just drive over here and well, we could put this trailer under the pipe on fertilizing master, fertilizer master, and drive down. There isn't any manure left, actually. Just let him stand there and can empty. I need to put in more manure there. I'm going to see anything going on there with the oil radish. Got 1.5 pallets. Yeah, they have actually grown up. Seems to be. So I'm not ready. I don't know if they are ready to cultivate down already or what. I don't know. Let's see. Growing, he says. So I have no idea how this works, actually. Is there any information about oil radish here? Oil radish. Oil radish is a special crop, as you can tell, as you don't harvest in the end, but dig it in once the plant are visible. Okay, so I can actually cultivate them already. So we just stop time here, let slow it down, and get the tractor and cultivate them down. So that's a new good thing. Oops. Let's just park him here. And get the big vent. Cedar there, I'm going to use it later on. Just gonna cultivate the oil radish. We have been talking about me and Johnny to do maybe some live streaming, testing that, see how that is going to go. I'm not sure about how the quality on that streaming will be, because my internet will be really hard on, because I will be hosting the game for Johnny to play with me, and I will be uploading it to YouTube at the same time. So I don't know how that is going to be go with the quality, but it will be could be quite nice to test that in some way. Just need to have somebody watching when we are actually testing it and see if it is going to have any quality at all. My internet connection is quite good, but maybe not that good. It could have issues when I'm actually hosting the game too, because I'm sending and receiving from Johnny in Australia and then sending my information to YouTube. So I don't know if it is doable. I just have to test it. I haven't got all these stuff that you should need for streaming. I have think about Twitch, but that will be when I gotten all the equipment that I need, like capture card and such, to help to get as good quality as possible. So we will find out soon. Maybe we'll test that in the weekend. Live streaming. I have done what, 3 live streams before, and they were fairly good quality on that one. I think I haven't seen any complaints about them yet, so I don't know. Just put a hired worker here. Let's see the fertilizing. How is the fertilizing going to look like? I have no idea. Could actually just speed up time and let it be ready for morning. I think all animals are in good shape. Yeah, they will actually go okay for to next day. I think. Don't think there is going to be any problem. So we got, what was it, 59 cows now. So we got one more cow in the herd. Wondering how it that is going to affect our money. We got, what was it, 25,000 yesterday for the milk. So is that going to be more today? Hopefully. We'll really soon see how that is going to be. Really soon here. No. 24,978. Actually got less this time than we had yesterday. That's strange. Did the milk go down in price over the night? Over the day? I didn't think so that it would, but I don't know. Let's see, any changes on we'll need to fertilize one more time there. As you can see, this stripe here, and probably here too. So I don't know if this is actually going to be worth it or just more fun to do it a little bit different on fertilizing stage. Well, if I understand this, every layer of fertilizer is 30%, and when you have the field plowed, it gives you 10% more. So 3 times 30% is 90, and then the 10% for plowing. So the oil radius is actually not giving you more fertilizing than just one layer of normal fertilizer, if I'm understanding this right. So if this is worth it, I don't think so. It's making more work because you need to cultivate it afterwards anyway. And as you can see, it's not giving you that much fertilizing anyway. You're going to need to fertilize these stripes anyway, so I don't know. Well, I have at least tested it and see what it is all about. And that's at least something. Oh, he will finish this, and I wanted to take this one and empty the seed trailer and fill him with pig feed. Could actually slow down time now. Whoa, driving into a pole here and not paying attention to anything. There, 17,000 liters. So we need to fill this one with both manure and slurry again. And we're probably not going to be able to empty it totally. I don't think so. We need some grain too, wheat, and we don't have any. Yeah, we could actually. Good. So let's take one load of pig feed, and I think we will say that good for today. Well, he is filling. Let's see how he is going. I wonder if I could have just used the cedar and just plow it, cultivate it down in the same time as I was seeding. Could have if I had a cedar that actually cultivated at the same time. But this Amazon Condor actually is doing that, even though it doesn't have a cultivator. I don't know why. Well, it's good that I did test this, because I haven't done that before. So now we know how this works. You can cultivate them down right away when they are visible on the field. So it's just to take the cultivator and put them in the ground. It actually is a good nutrients to the ground in real life. It gives the ground some extra nutrients. So it's maybe good to do this once in a while, but even though it hasn't any value in the game, except it is just a fertilizer. So doing stuff a little bit different, at least. And if you have any opinion on this, please tell me what you think. Do you think this is worth it to do this, or it's just for more fun, extra stuff that you can do? But please give me a comment about that. So we have now two fields ready to seed, and two fields to harvest. A lot of stuff need to be done here at the farm too. So we are actually having more than enough to do. I really need to move that header here. Where is... there. So let's go and give the pigs some feed. The first load of mixed feed from these machines. The money is actually starting to look better. We are getting close to be able to do something. As I talked about changing the telehandler, I have talked about changing the harvester. Let's see. As you can see, it will fill up everything equally. Now they have gotten what they need for 6 days. Easy, isn't it? And we even had a little bit left. So we are having no problems for pig feed. They have more than enough. We had 150,000 liters in this mixed feeder there, and we still have 119,000 something, I think, still left there. So we have no problem with food for even both cows and pigs right now. So there. Well, we have done a little thing of a lot of things today. Filled the mixed feeders and fertilizing stuff and tested the oil radish and everything, so there have been done a lot of things today. But I really hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please give me the thumbs up. Anything to add, please give me a comment. And new subscribers, new viewers, please subscribe. And thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.